Hello, dear students. Welcome to the English class. In the first part, we studied about the first stanza of the poem, Romeo and Juliet. We will proceed to the next stanza here. Here we find description of Romeo's beauty by Juliet. Okay, before studying this, we should know the background. See, how already we studied how Romeo was fallen in love with the first sight of Juliet. See, after some days, this Juliet saw Romeo, and equally she was also fallen in love with Romeo. Now the situation is Juliet is waiting for Romeo in order to meet him in the night. See, the situation is every day in the night they used to meet in the balcony of the house. So Juliet is waiting for Romeo in the balcony of her house. There she is watching in the towards the dark sky. Now she asks dark sky to call her Romeo immediately, to bring her Romeo immediately. Why? Because she is waiting for him. She is very much eager to meet Romeo. So see, the situation of the stanza is Juliet is also fallen in love with Romeo. She expresses her love feelings for Romeo, and he was accepted her love, and she was also accepted his love, and they used to meet in hidden at night time. In one of the night, she was waiting for him. She is very eager to meet him. So in that despair, she speaks these poetic words. See, we will study what she says. Come night, come Romeo, come though day in night, for thou wilt lie upon the wings of night, whiter than new snow on a raven's back. Come gentle night, come loving black browed night, give me my Romeo, and when I shall die, take him and cut him out in little stars, and he will make the face of heaven so fine that all the worlds will be in love with night and pay no worship to the garish sun. Here for your concern, I wrote meanings of the words, of new words here. Thou means you. This is from Old English. Thou means you. Thou means will you. Wilt means bend. Lie means sleep. Wilt means bend. Lie means sleep. New snow means charmness of the Romeo is compared to the new snow. Raven means crow here. Black broad night means dark night. Black broad night means here dark night. Cut him out in little stars means she wanted to make him immortalize, so she asked the night to cut him into little stars and arrange him in the night sky as a constellation. Okay, the face of heaven here, it symbolizes night sky. Face of heaven means night sky. There is a comparison. Okay, as we know in poem, there was a comparison. Always they expresses ideas with comparison. Okay, garish means harsh, brutal. Okay, Now we will study the poem in detail. See, she says, come night, come Romeo. Come, she calls night and Romeo together because whole day she was waiting for the night. Why she was waiting for the night? Because in night her Romeo will come to meet her. So she asks night to come along with Romeo. She asks night to come along with Romeo. Come night, come Romeo, come you day in night. See, in the night Romeo will come to meet her, but she don't want to meet him in that dark night. It means in hidden, she don't want to meet him. So she asks night, come along with Romeo, but come as a day in the night. Come as, don't come as dark night, come as bright day in that night. For you wilt lie upon the wings of night. See, she says, Romeo and night, both of you come together, come early. She is very much eager to meet Romeo. So she asks night to bring her Romeo to her. Come, come like a day in the night when she is there to meet her beloved Romeo. It is not a dark night for her. It is like a bright day for her. For thou wilt lie upon the wings of night. She asks night, night to bring her Romeo by lying on the wings of that dark night. Here there is a comparison. She says that this night has wings like a bird. Okay? Birds are only having the wings. But she says this dark night has wings. She asks night to bring her Romeo on those wings lying. See, she asks Romeo to lie upon those dark wings and come towards her, come to meet her. It is just a symbolic idea, she says. Along with night, when night comes, immediately you, Romeo, you come to meet me. Then, whiter than new snow on a raven's back, she says, when Romeo and night together coming towards me, to meet me, when Romeo was lying upon the wings of night, it looks like a new snow was spreading, new snow was lying on the raven's back. See, when both together were coming towards her, how does it appear? It appears here, she compares, Juliet compares Romeo's charm to the new snow and that dark night to the crow. See, how when you sprinkle some snow on the wings of the crow, how it was attractive. In the same way, my Romeo, when he comes to meet me in the dark night, he appears like a new snow. His charm was compared to that new snow. Okay, question will arise here. Next. Come, gentle night, come, loving black browed night. Give me my Romeo, and when I shall die, take him and cut him out in little stars. See, how great feeling she has for her beloved. She says she is waiting for him, and she asks the night to bring her Romeo, and Romeo must lie upon the wings of that dark night. It looks like a new snow on the raven's back, and so she requests night, that come gentle night, you are carrying my beloved Romeo, so gently you come towards me. Come loving night, come gentle night, come loving night, black broad night. See, she is very, this line shows that she is very much eager to meet her beloved Romeo. So she asks, gently, O black night, gently come towards me. O my loving night, you are going to bring my Romeo to me. So come gently towards me. O black broad night, give me my Romeo. You come early and make me meet my Romeo very much early. Give my Romeo to me. See what happens here. Every night she is going to meet her Romeo. So she says, when night you will come along with you, you are going to bring my Romeo. So you are very loving to me. So she says, loving black broad night, come and give my Romeo. She asks night to give her Romeo. Why? Because every day she used to meet her Romeo in the night. When dark night will cover the earth, she is going to meet her beloved. So, and when I shall die, take him and cut him out in little stars. See, her feelings are very much true and genuine for Romeo here. So she says, now I will ask you to bring my Romeo to me, give my Romeo to me, but when I shall die, don't keep him here, take him, cut him out in little stars. See, with this line we come to know that she wanted to immortalize her love forever. After their death also, this world can remember their love. So she wanted to cut her Romeo into little stars. She says to the dark night, when she shall die, again take the Romeo along with you and cut him into little stars and arrange him in the night sky as a constellation. Why? Because the people of the world, the people of the earth can remember their love and divine love forever. Okay? Her love feelings were very much genuine for Romeo here. We come to know with this line, we come to know that Juliet really had a genuine, true love feelings for her beloved. Why? Because after their death also, she wanted to immortalize their love. Then, and he will make the face of heaven so fine, oh black broad night, if you cut him into little stars and arrange him as a stars in the night sky, he will make the face of heaven so fine. He will make that dark night sky as bright. Why? Because he is always charming. The charm of Romeo make the face of heaven, means night sky. The charm of Romeo will make the night sky as daylight. Okay? He will make the face of heaven so fine if you arrange him as little stars in the night sky. The night sky will glow with the charm of Romeo. Then that all the world will be in love with night. See, always the people of the world were fallen in love with daylight. They always having some negligence, some neglect towards the night. Why? Because that dark night is no useful for them. So, here, when you cut my Romeo into little stars, you arrange him in the night sky as a little stars, his charm is going to glow the night sky with the brightness. Then all the world will be love with night. Now the world is having some hatredness towards the night. They will started loving the night and pay no worship to the garish sun. See, the people of the world always worshipping the sun. Why? Because every day morning the sun is going to bring some brightness, some hopes for them. But at the night they don't have any hopes. So they have some negligence towards night. But the charming beauty of Romeo, if it started glowing the night, here Juliet feels that the people of the world will stop worshipping the garish. Garish means harsh. Sometimes sun was very harsh. So the worship means here deity, devotion. These people of the earth stopping devoting the sun. Why? Because he is bringing brightness for them. They started worshipping the night also. If you arranged my Romeo as a little stars in the night sky. See how wonderful feeling she has for her beloved Romeo. See, all together here, Juliet's love feelings for Romeo is genuine and true, and she compares her charm to the new snow, and she asks night to bring Romeo, and she asks Romeo to lie upon the wings of the night. Night and Romeo, both of you come together to me. And she asks night, when she shall die, take him again and cut him into little stars and arrange him in the night sky as a little stars, as a constellation, in order to make their love immortalize. She wanted to, here in this line, we can understand that she wanted to immortalize her love with Romeo after her death also. And further she says, the people of the earth stop showing devotion, showing some worship for the garish sun. Why? Because her Romeo's charm is going to brighten the night sky. So here we come to know that how genuine feelings she has for her beloved Romeo. See, like this, she describes her eagerness and her genuine feelings, her eagerness to meet her Romeo. Here, Romeo in that dark night. Okay, this is about Romeo's description by Juliet. Okay, dear students, now we will proceed towards question answers. We will find some objective type questions here. In the first comprehension, see, the phrase "teach the torch to burn bright" suggests. See, here he used torches to compare the beauty of Juliet. Romeo used this. Juliet's glow is brighter than the light of the torch. Her beauty is capable of enabling the torches to burn bright. Her beauty surpasses the brightness of the light. Here, C1. Why? Because this is totally wrong. And this answer is also somewhat correct. But here, he says, Juliet's glow is brighter than the light of the torch. But here, the same meaning is also we find here, but this answer is very much suited for the question. Her beauty surpasses the brightness of the light. That Juliet has the beauty which can surpasses the brightness of the light. Then he says, she is the girl who taught the lamp or taught the light to burn bright. Okay, equivalent meaning. Next, for earth to dear suggests that the lady's beauty is. See, for earth to dear, here it says rare beauty, expensive beauty. Okay, expensive beauty. The measure done connects the completion of Romeo's admiration of Juliet's beauty. Second one, dance organized by Lord Capulet, glorification of Juliet's charm. See, after the measure done, he wanted to touch her. He says, the measure done, I will touch her, I will search the place where she was standing. I will touch her in order to make my rude hands blessed. He says, no? See here, Romeo's admiration of the Juliet's. He admires, he praises her beauty with these lines. The line, did my heart love till now, suggests. This question he asks himself. Romeo feels he has fallen in love. Yes, Romeo has been attracted before. No, Romeo feels this is true love. Okay? He asks this question himself, that now he come across with the true love. Third one. The phrase new snow suggests new snow. Okay, new snow. The charming beauty of Romeo is compared to the new snow. Love as pure as snow. Description of Romeo's charm. Juliet's discreet love for Romeo. Okay, this is B. Then, description of Romeo's charm. What do you think the phrase face of heaven signifies? Face of heaven, here it means night sky. Okay? Juliet says, if you cut my Romeo into little stars, arrange him in the night sky, he will make fine the face of heaven. He will brighten, he will glow the night sky. Okay? Face of heaven means night sky. See? For 4 marks, there are 4 important questions. All 4 you have to prepare here. First one, what similes does Romeo use to convey Juliet's beauty? For this, whatever similes he used a torch, snow widow, okay, diamond, rich jewel, and he compared all the others. Other ladies to the crow, all these things you have to describe for 4 marks. Whole summary of the first stanza you have to describe for the first question. How, according to Juliet, would Romeo be immortalized to the world? See, we studied now only that how this Juliet is very much eager to meet Romeo in the night time, so she asks night to bring Romeo. When she shall die, Again, take the Romeo along with you and cut him into little stars. Arrange him in the night sky as a constellation in order to glow the night sky. His Romeo is going to make heaven, face of heaven, so nice. Like this, she wanted to immortalize her true love after their death also. Okay, second stanza summary you have to write here for the second question. Okay, comprehension third, again two more questions. One, comment on the contrasting imagery in the poem. See, so many contrasting imageries were used here. Dark and white, day and night contrasting imageries were, because in order to tell the differentiation, they used this contrastary imageries. What purpose does it serve in highlighting the intensity of love? See, darkness is compared, darkness and brightness, these contrastary image, and day and night, these contrastary images were used in order to show the intensity and genuinity of the love for they are having for each other. Okay, then between Romeo and Juliet, whose love do you think is more fascinating and intense? Here, between Romeo and Juliet, we think that Juliet's love is more intense than Romeo's. Both are having implicit love for each other, but somewhat Juliet's love feelings are more fascinated and more intense towards Romeo. Why? Because Romeo just described how beautiful the girl is, and her beauty is divine beauty. Her beauty is expensive beauty, and her beauty is rare beauty. But this Juliet says, Romeo's beauty is charming one, attractive one, and she used many contrastary images also. But lastly, she wanted to immortalize their love after their death also. That idea tells us that Juliet's love feelings for Romeo is more fascinated than him, more intensive for than Romeo's love. Okay, dear students, this is about Romeo and Juliet poem. We completed this one. After that, I will give some objective type questions and nearly 3 to 4 long answer type questions answer. Okay, thank you one and all.